Hey everyone, how are you doing? You have Mike here, and today I'm going to show you how to build this DIY bucket system. This is something pretty cool that I've been working on over the last month or so, and I'm pretty excited to show it off to you guys here today. So I'm going to start you out with a short couple minute clip showing you all the action work and all how I built it, and then we're going to come sit down and we're going to talk about it. So stay tuned. Hey guys, how are y'all doing? You have Mike here, and today we are going to show you our new hydroponic system. So basically this is in four parts. We have our buckets, we have our air system, we have our draining system, because this is a circulating system, and we also have our fill system, is what you see here. So we do have another bucket off camera, which has our pump, and it has a return, like you see on each one of these other buckets. So I want to be clear that when we started this off, there's basically two ways that you could do this. There is a bottom drain and there is a top drain. Each has their plus sides and downsides. And I guess I'm going to cover that really quickly right here. So why we went with a top with an overflow system, basically is because the water level is going to stay level all the time. If you go by a bottom feed system, by a bottom drain system, the water levels tend to go up and down. This here is going to keep the water level all the time. So a downside to this here means that water changes are going to be a little bit more difficult, because at the end of the day, the water is never going to go below this fitting. So that means we have to suck the water out of the bucket. And I have a piece of poly in each bucket, which is basically like a straw that goes down to the bottom. And from there we suck it out. So we have come up with a system to easily remove the water. And that's one of the reasons why we had chosen to go with this system. Another reason is actually a pretty big one. So when you put the drain on the bottom, the roots tend to go into the drain, which tends to clog the drain, which usually tends to have a bucket overflow, or there could potentially be problems for that. The roots will not go to the bottom and then come back up and come back out the hole. That is not going to happen. We have enough experience with hydroponics and seeing how the last roots went to know that that is not going to be a problem. So there actually is another reason why we went with the top overflow system. If we were to have a leak in any one of these valves, if it was on the bottom, that could be catastrophic, because that would give the opportunity for all the water in all of the system, including the reservoir, to empty out. So this way here, if there was something that happened, started to leak, it would be a very minimal leak, and it wouldn't be able to drain out any of our system. So everything is all isolated with it being set up like this. All right, guys, so I briefly did explain why we have this black piece of poly sticking out of each of the bucket. This is kind of like a straw, like I had mentioned. But I do want to show how I actually get the water out of the buckets. So this here is what we call a Python water changer. It usually has a long piece that comes off of it. Anyone that has a fish tank, this is used to basically suck the bottom of the fish tank, the gravel vac. So with the poly actually fits right into the end of this, like so. Makes a airtight suction. Now with the water, basically how this works is water comes down with this valve open, and it makes a suction through this line. I can't remember the scientific term, but basically it makes a suction, and it's going to suck out the water out of each of the buckets. So as a quick little example, this here is basically how it works. I walk over, pop this into the bucket, down she works. It's going to drain out the bucket. It's only going to take about a minute to drain out. I just shoved it on there quickly. But that's basically how the water change system works. We repeat that through all of our buckets, and good to go. Just so you guys can all see. So inside of each bucket, there is an air stone, which is done through these hard CO2 lines. And the reason why we use CO2 lines is because it's stiff. As soon as you put air to an air stone that is intended to want to float, we don't want that to happen. So the first step we kind of had to do here was find out how far, how close to the water we wanted. So our buckets, once we put in the air and the air is all rumbling, it's actually only about this far under our bucket. So if the basket is sitting pretty close to the water, which is kind of where we wanted it. So as you can see that where they are in the buckets, this here is actually 3.5 gallons, so they won't fill up any more than 3.5 gallons. So I know I've got 3.5 gallons, 3.5 gallons, 3.5 gallons, and 3.5 gallons. That's kind of important to know too, because your reservoir needs to be big enough to handle the water drop that's going to be eaten every day. So what we did do was, on our last grow, we had our blue monster, which was in one of these buckets. And it was actually pulling out close to about 0.5 gallon of water a day as a healthy plant before harvest. So 0.5 gallon of water out of the bucket, that means we got 2 gallons per day coming out of the bucket. We're probably going to have to go with a little bit bigger of a reservoir when it comes to flowering. But for right now, we're going to leave it as the bucket. There is another bucket at Walmart that was $10. It was 18 gallons, and it was just the perfect size to fit where we wanted it to go. So that is something we're probably going to do a little bit later on down the road. All right, guys, so this here is the inside of the bucket. As you can see, the water is flowing down. It's flowing in there pretty good. It's kind of staying at about the same level, which is what we're looking for. But this is what it was saying here. We're probably going to get this into a bigger bucket. This is only it's only holding 3.5 gallons, which is really not what we're looking for. So I just wanted to get this thing started. Let's plug this in and let's show you how it all works, how it all sounds. And we'll go from there. So we can see, so we did have this turned back on now. You can see, guys, we're not pumping a lot of water through there. This is not something that you need to pump a lot of water through. So we have a really low flow going through here. Like I said, it's enough to fill up the bucket in about 10 minutes. So enough to turn over about 6 times an hour. So I'm going to plug in the air pump. I'm not going to keep it plugged in for long just because it's a little bit louder and you won't be able to hear me talk right. So here we go. We've got the air pump turned on. And right now it's just set to pretty low power and it actually rumbles each bucket pretty good. But it does have the ability to just make everything really move. But that's a little bit unneeded for this setup. It's really not needed, so we're not going to leave it like that. So one thing that we are going to do with this system is this is going to be connected to our smart home. There is going to be a leak detector that sits into the middle of the floor down here. That is going to run our water pump onto a smart switch. So if for some reason something were to get clogged that we didn't know about, that we didn't see coming, and it did make a mess in this floor, it is going to kick off the pump and we're not going to have any more of a water mess than what already happened. So I think that's a really cool idea too. It's only going to cost us another $70 at this point, what we've put into this. What is another $70 to have that peace of mind? So like I said, we're going to have a water shutoff sensor that's going to come down on the floor, and that is going to be connected to our smart home technology, and we'll be able to know exactly what's going on in here at all times. If for any reason we see that the water's tripped or something, we at least know to come home and to try to get stuff back up and running. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all the hardware that we used to build all this. We'll go through all of the poly parts, all of the parts that we used, and everything. So let's go over a little bit of how much some of this stuff costs, because you guys are probably wondering. Looks like there's quite a bit of hardware here and stuff like that. And I'm not going to lie, it did cost quite a bit of money. So we have $34.70 into the buckets and lids. We have $75 into this active air pump. We have $101 in fittings. So that's all these T's that you have. This is your 3/4 inch male poly, 3/4 inch screw in one side, two poly. And we had 5 of those. We have 2 different types of T's. There's a T here, as you can see. There's also a T at this side over here. And altogether, $101.50 in fittings. We also had a can of spray paint, which we used to spray paint our buckets. And we also had about $20 in hosing, so there's another $30 there. And without buying the pump, we're looking at $240.20 for what we have here. Like I said, we did buy the pump. This part right here that we can see down for the water, which I'm going to give you a better view. This water shutoff valve here down here costs $20, so everything kind of adds up when you're looking at this system. Alright guys, so thank you very much for watching. If you guys have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them down below. I'm going to make sure that I put a list and everything else, every product that I used in this and everything in the description below. So if you guys, like I said, have any questions, please feel free to hit me up and I will do my best to help you out. So we'd like to thank everybody for watching. You all have yourself a great day and take care. Peace.